shut this noisy diesel off. And I'll give you a little tour of Pooper Palace. I always enjoy getting free things. Who doesn't? And so in making this outhouse, I re-sided it, and I'll insert a picture of what this looked like before. But how about that? You got some nice diffused light, and boom. Luckily, you can't see in there. But I put a little cabinet in here with some, try to keep the toilet paper dry. And you never know when you got to kill a bee, especially in the summertime. It's pretty terrible. I feel like I'm a real sucker for old cedar siding. It's just cedar fencing. It's free. People get rid of their old fences. And so it makes a great rustic wrap. This little shed is a 6 by 5.5 or something. And put a little metal roof on it. And then over here we have a little 8 by 10 cabin. I mean, you can barely say it's much of a cabin. It's really so small in there, there's hardly any room to even change your mind. But I'd like to add a 14 by 16 out where Wally's at, up to here. Make it a lot more usable, excuse me. And here we are on the deck. This is a little 8 by 16. And look at that, pretty deep snow. This little cabin was something I built just a few years ago. It's kind of dingy and it's clean, but well, not enough room to do anything with yet. But built it for some homeless couple that was living at our church parking lot. And so we housed them in that for, oops, sorry, my hand's in the way, for one winter to keep them warm. And then they eventually got a home and actually got a job. And so I made it portable. It's got skids underneath it, and moved it back up here and put it up here by the pond. And then I had these 2 8x8 deck panels that were, I just sistered them together and made a little deck, kind of hard to see with snow on it. But I'm gonna add on another few more feet to this deck when I add on to the cabin. And I wanna basically have big windows on the front of the cabin and enough room to have family come up and visit. It's not gonna have any electricity. We're too far away, and that's big bucks to run power up here. But I wanna put a little wood stove in it, insulate it well, and just make it comfortable enough for people to visit, and but not so nice that they don't want to leave eventually, right? So this is pretty much the conclusion of this, what I call the park area, and that's all grass out there. Great area to set up tents and play volleyball. And anyway, people always ask that, are we going to do weddings up here? No. I've done that before. It's mainly just for sharing with friends and I guess you guys now. So we'll get back in here and we'll head back down to the house. And on our final installment of the descend back down to the lower property, just kind of want to show you guys the view out to the valley. And we're sitting up here at the area that I call the Hobbit Hut. Yeah, there's no hobbits, but I don't know, kind of a catchy name. Stored a few implements up here to get them out of the way of the lower area. But this is a little garden shed that my dad actually built quite a few years ago. And well, I didn't have use of it down the lower property, so I just took the forks on the backhoe and threw a chain around the walls, and I carried it up here and set it in its new home. And it's really being underutilized at the moment. There's some old yokes up there from 1800 days, but you hear a hum in there. That is the sound of the aerator motor. I did run power up to here. We're about 180 feet from the shop down below. And that way I could run this aerator. And then I ran about 700 feet of PVC line up over the dam, up into the pond, which is directly back in this way. So snowy and so thick and underbrush, you really can't see it. But that's what runs the emitters that are submersed under the pond up there. And that's really helped a lot. Apparently this little unit is supposed to run 14 years or something like that. So, hope it does. But it's been a drastic improvement on the water quality of the pond. And I think eventually I'm gonna put a little French door on the front. Maybe make it another little cabin that family can stay in when they're camping out. I think a guy could probably just shut off that thing when you want to sleep at night, unless people want the noise to sleep. Some people run a fan, you know, but anyway, that's the Hobbit Hut. And then again, that's the view down to the valley. And, we're only a couple hundred feet higher than the valley, but, we sure get a lot of good snow up here, just being a couple hundred feet higher than down below. So that concludes today's tour. Hope you enjoyed it. Catch you next time.